DJ Douzable played in the NFL, just retired for 10 years. Jets, Jacksonville, Rams, Minnesota. Your last year, Lee J, was in 2017 for San Francisco.
Correct.
So you got Kyle Shanahan. Jimmy G was not there yet.
Not in the beginning. We traded for him halfway through the season.
Okay, so give me a what are your gut feeling here on Jimmy G? Did you like him? What do you hear about him? What did you see?
Jimmy, a.k.a. Jimmy Smooth, is what I called him in the locker room. He was literally right across from me in the locker room, and we would talk all the time. Jimmy wants to be great. You can tell that he came probably from a New England background. He does almost everything that Tom does, but he switches it up a little bit. The way he preps and just his mindset to the game is amazing to me. I think he could be really great. It really hurt me last year when he went down early in the season.
Is he fiery? Is he, you know, Brady can be really...
Jimmy definitely could be fiery. He gets a lot of times he does the breakdown before we go out on the field. That's how fiery he is. And sometimes it depends on what team you are. A lot of quarterbacks don't do that. You might get a defensive lineman or a linebacker. But Jimmy is the one that calls it up before we go out on the field. And as soon as he came in, you could just feel it was like a breath of fresh air for the locker room when he came and we traded for him. And we ended up winning 6 games down the stretch that year.
You did. And he didn't have nearly the roster you have today.
Exactly. His roster this year... they have to compete and win this year. And I think there's a lot of expectations, as there should be, because they've spent a lot of money in free agency. They brought in D4. They traded for him. They also brought in Quan Alexander, who's a really good player, too.
Tampa Bay linebacker, super athletic.
Definitely. And a three-headed monster at running back. You don't know who's going to play. I know Kyle Shanahan's excited about that, having 3 good running backs to play and can manipulate defenses and put them all over the field. And all 3 of those backs can catch the ball at the backfield, which is very dangerous.
Yeah, Kyle Shanahan loves that, by the way. That's what he did in Washington. That's what he did in Atlanta. He likes his backs who can catch. All right, I come across as grumpy old man when I say I don't like Baker Mayfield. It looks like he was way too good at the chugging beer thing. I do think quarterbacks are different. Michael Vick told me a story once early in his career before a game. He was rah, 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 and Dan Reeves said, you're the quarterback.
Yeah.
You're not a running back. What did you make of Baker? Do I sound like an old cranky guy?
You actually don't, Colin, especially during training camp. Your franchise quarterback can't be out there chugging beers. Now, we've seen in the offseason Aaron Rodgers, Matt Stafford, but the difference was that was in the offseason. You can't be doing that in the middle of training camp when you're the face of the franchise. I love Baker, his fiery attitude and the way he comes to work, but there's certain things as a franchise quarterback you cannot be seen doing on camera.
Yeah. Now, Sam Darnold's the opposite personality. You played with the Jets. What do you hear, and do you like Sam?
I hear a lot about Sam Darnold, that he's even killed, and you want that as a quarterback, that's never too high or too low. So even when he throws interceptions, it's not, I want to say he just brushes them off, but he goes back to the next play, and all right, let's get it, guys. I think if he can turn down his turnovers and maybe go up on his touchdowns, he had 15 interceptions last year and only 17 touchdown passes. If he can get to like 25, 26 with that defense they have and also having Le'Veon Bell, a little safety net for him, I think he can be really great.
When you were with the Jets, there's always been this perception, at least to me, there is some level of dysfunction. Yep. Not Cleveland dysfunction, perhaps, but some level. When you were there, did you ever sense that?
I wouldn't say it was dysfunction.
Because you won there, didn't you?
We went 8-8 my first year with Rex in 2013, and then 2014 we had an offseason. We had a lot of issues going on in the locker room, and they fired Rex, and then we brought in Todd Bowles in 2015, which we did win. We went 10-6, and that was the year where I feel like it's kind of like this year's Jets team, where they brought in a lot of free agents. That year we brought in Brandon Marshall, we brought Revis back, we brought Cromartie back, we added Buster Screen at our nickel slot corner, and James Carpenter. Kind of like this year when they brought in C.J. Mosley. I think Brian Poole, a guy a lot of guys aren't really talking about as their nickel guy, he's made an immediate impact in camp this year. And they've brought in a lot of different guys, especially the offensive line, Kaliche Oshimile, Ryan Khalil, and they just traded for Alex Lewis. I think they're building it the way we built it from the inside out. And anytime you build it through the trenches, you can be successful.
That's what Philadelphia has done through the years. New England, O-line, D-line, secondary. Let's talk about the Raiders. They'll be on HBO tonight. I work with Gruden at my former employer. He's a TV star.
Yeah.
So he was a football coach, and then he became a TV star. And I've always said TV is really easy money. It's hard to let go of it, right? Mm. So once you're a TV star, you may go back to the kitchen as a chef or the football team as a coach, but you're still a TV star.
No question.
And I think it can be distracting. Now, Joe Gibbs left, went into NASCAR. Okay, that's a different business. Definitely. Then he came back into the NFL. But once you're a television star, it doesn't matter if you're Gordon Ramsay, a chef, Robert Irvine, or you're John Gruden. It's hard. You're always a TV star.
Yeah.
I think they're too distracted. I don't love what I see.
Yeah.
Your thoughts?
There's a lot going on there, as you said, Colin. I mean, for one, you got Hard Knocks, which is automatically going to bring a lot of hoopla around your team, which airs tonight, matter of fact. So we'll see what they've been doing in training camp. And then you bring in AB, who, not, I want to say a controversial player, but has had some issues off the field, but is a great player. And right now, he's not even playing for you. So that alone right there, there's a lot going on with that. He's your brand-new toy. Of course, you want him out there playing. You traded away two first-rounders in Khalil Mack, which is a once-in-a-generational player, and Amari Cooper last year. And my thing is, the compensation you get back for them, the first rounders, they have to hit. They have to be playmakers right away. Because when you trade away a guy like Khalil Mack, you saw in Chicago what he did. Not just for that defense, he ignited that offense and the whole team. The whole city of Chicago was behind that team, and it took them to the playoffs. So when you trade away two players like that, I mean, you almost have to win. And those first-round picks, they have to be good.
Yeah, I mean, when you know, it's funny about, like, Antonio Brown, Odell Beckham a little bit. Nobody disputes their talent. Yeah. Pittsburgh's like, we're done with it. Giants are like, we're done with it. Now, Pittsburgh and the Giants historically win. The Raiders and the Browns, last 10 years, losers, are like, we'll take those noisy guys.
Yeah.
I get people having unique personalities. Were you ever on a team in your 10 years where you did feel there was a guy? I mean, some people said Rex Ryan was disrupted. Did you ever feel like there was a player that it did pull at the fabric of the team?
I wouldn't say player. I would say, like you said, Rex. Everybody thought Rex was a little bit distracting, but us as players, we love Rex. He was a player's coach, and I feel like the energy he brought day in and day out made us really want to run through a brick wall for him. And you saw that on his defenses. Like, every year, his defense was in the top 10. So I wouldn't say we had a player, per se. We were like, man, this guy's really draining us. The energy's bad in the locker room. But a lot of people said that Rex Ryan was that guy for us, even though he wasn't a player. But I feel like Rex, what he did and the job that he did in New York, really helped out on the defensive end. Now, when I played, we didn't have a lot of offensive help when Rex was there, and we didn't get a lot of that help until 2015 when Bowles got there, when they signed a lot of players in the offseason. But I feel like Rex did a great job in New York.
Lijay Douzabal is joining us, 10 years in the NFL. Your father was Haitian. You came as a young child. You came to Florida. You got Central Florida. You really are the NFL. We say this all the time.
Yeah.
You can spot basketball talent by 15.
Yeah.
You know Dwight Howard, Kobe, LeBron. Football talent's different. Half the NFL is undrafted. You are the classic NFL story where you go to camp, some undrafted guy from a directional school comes in like you.
Definitely.
And 10 years later, you're still earning checks. Go back to your history. When you go into these camps now, can you spot guys early on? You're like, I don't even know where that school is.
Yeah.
Do the young unsung guys like you, do they stand out early?
It just depends. To me, when I see an unsung hero or unsung undrafted guy, it's usually based off his effort, and that's what I always try to do. I used to always make sure I had more effort than anybody in the field. Nobody was going to outwork me. My father used to tell me this when I was younger. When I was in high school getting ready to sign my Division I scholarship, I had the athletic director tell me that nobody in our team was Division I worthy on this high school team. And my dad used to tell me this every day, how bad do you want it, son? So I used to write that on a piece of paper and put it in my locker, how bad do I want it, along with what stats I wanted that year, and I would look at it every day. I put one on the back of my door in my master bedroom and in my locker room, and I would look at that every single day, and it would fuel me, how bad do you want it? People used to tell me all the time what I could and couldn't do, but I would tell people there's no way I'm not going to make it to the NFL. And I told myself coming into the NFL, I was going to play no less than 8 years. I was going to say, my marker was 8 to 10, and I made it to year 10.
Great story. Lijay, 10 years plus in the NFL, does some Jets broadcasting as well. Pleasure to meet you. Hour 3 is next.